from Buenos Aires. For the first time ever, Total Wipeout in 3D.
That's not 3D, is it?
Anyway, tonight, a group of really hard Brits, including a granny, a sleep researcher and a musician, will be competing in a contest that's been compared to the Olympics. By me, just then. But instead of a gold medal, one competitor will win a big trophy and £10,000. Let the games begin.
Welcome to Total Wipeout. Have I got a show for you? Have we got a show for them? Oh. Is that it, then? Okay. Just show the kitten, then. It's all okay. I found the remote. We do have a show for you, and apparently this is what's in it.
The Qualifier. 12 will qualify. Crash Mountain. 5 will reach the summit. Dizzy Dummies. 3 will be less dizzy. And the grand final, the Wipeout Zone. One will win £10,000.
Whilst many TV shows are being accused of dumbing down, personally, I'm a big fan of dumbing up. To assess the current state of affairs at Argentina's premier foam-based obstacle course, here's Amanda Byron to conduct an in-depth interrogation of today's first contestant. Serious stuff. Gripping.
Joined now at the top of the qualifier by Nikki from Rotherham, who's a donor carer. Are you going to make that look easy out there today?
I'd like to say yes. However, I am very clumsy and have a tendency to go the wrong way. That's why my nickname's Satnav.
My name is Satnav and there's only one winner here, so everyone else can get lost!
All right.
So off goes Nikki, and she is going in the right direction so far. Just needs to navigate herself upward now. Yeah. As Nikki familiarises herself with the pontoon, it's time to reintroduce the first obstacle. It's back again. A long beam, 6 heavy swinging bags and thousands of gallons of stinky brown water. It's the heavy bag beam. Time to see if Satnav finds her way over here. Watch out! Oh. Seems to have run into some heavy traffic there. Unexpectedly. Right, Nikki now needs to find her way up the stairs and try and avoid the second set of bags. Here we go.
Oh, very good.
Yes.
No, the wrong way.
I've worked out what the problem is. She's only got the Western Europe map.
Yes, you see.
Now she's heading the right way, and it's a quick dash too. The Sucker Punch. 22 precision fists with one mission, to inflict maximum pummelage. Only the fastest 12 will make it through to the next round, so Nikki could do with the Argentinian map here.
After 200 yards, bear right and get punched in the face.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect. She got punched in the face. At least she followed those directions to the letter. Nikki now looking a bit lost as she marches up the ramp to the next obstacle. It's the big red balls.
Oh, ow! All right, that's enough!
And for those scaredy cats who don't want to jump, there is a little motivational aid. The motivator. Here goes Nikki.
No, she's on the slip road.
Oh, dear.
Turn around where possible.
Yeah, too late. Time is ticking away for Nikki, so it's a swim and a climb to the final obstacle.
Don't mean a thing. If it ain't got that swing.
It's a swing onto a thing, then a jump onto that thing, then the clock thing stops, sort of thing. A simple swing and a jump to the finished podium now for Nikki. Come on. Here we go. Oh, no. Just no. I'll see what happens. She went down towards the water when she should have gone straight on towards the finish line. Never trust a sat nav. Nikki takes an alternative route to the finish podium.
You have now reached your destination.
In a time of 3 minutes and 36 seconds.
You did extremely well. We're proud of you. Go get dried off. We'll see you a little bit later.
Thank you. Heck, that was an odd qualifier.
Yes. Next to tackle the qualifier is 40-year-old army musician Simon.
Simon, welcome.
Oh, welcome, Amanda.
Thank you. Listen, what would Her Majesty think of one of her finest taking on the Total Wipeout course in name of Queen and country?
I think she'd quite enjoy it, really.
She does love Total Wipeout, you know. Hi, Queenie.
Oh, now we're all going to the tower. Okay. Why is Amanda drinking a yard of ale? Oh, off he goes. It's the knees that do it. It's a good landing. Simon has been in the army for 20 years, so he's no stranger to obstacle courses, but as a band member, he probably had to do them whilst holding a clarinet or something. Or one of those big xylophones, you know the ones. Or a really massive drum. That'd be difficult. Right, a royal appointment with a heavy bag beam now. Past the first one. Ooh, this is looking good. Past the first two, three. Now the fourth. This is looking very good. And the fifth and the sixth. Oh,
no. No,
one step too far, but Simon just about managed to keep the crown jewels intact. Sucker punch now. Will Simon's army band training be of any use here? Not in the slightest. Onto the big red royal balls now. Can I say that? I did, yeah. OK, come on. Oh, he's onto the second ball. Get out.
This is for you, Queenie.
Yes, yes. I mean, no. It is. Making his way to the third. Here we go. Oh, no. No. No knighthood for him, probably. If it was on the cards. It's not now. At least he can keep a steady rhythm. I actually wanted to march them.
Sorry, Queenie. I tried.
Amanda, she's not watching. She's just not. And Big Band Simon climbs to the finish podium in 3 minutes 25. Stand at ease. When you think of Grandma, a few things might spring to mind, like knitting, boiled sweets, maybe even mobility scooters. What definitely doesn't spring to mind is Fee, the coolest grandma in Penzance. What if she knitted that silver thing herself?
Nanny Fee, that's me, and I'm here to put the glam back into grand.
I'm faintly scared. Anyone else? Okay, off she goes. Wow, she's quick. Has she spotted a jumble sale somewhere or something, maybe? Right, sprinting along the pontoons, approaching the heavy bag beam. Come on, Fee. Oh, yes, no. Oh, no, Grandma's had a fall. She'd have done a hit. They always do. Well, she may be a grandma, but this is a very quick time so far. Onto the big red balls. That's good. That's very good. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Just the swing thing left. This is one fast granny. Here we go. Swing and the landing. Oh, that was good. Just a short leap to go. Yes, yes! No! That sort of thing really shouldn't happen to a grandma. It's just wrong. Granny McPhee climbs to the finish in an amazing 2 minutes and 17 seconds, despite the complete absence of a stairlift.
Glamorous or what?
Yeah, glamorous. This is 18-year-old Ben from Wales. He's the youngest competitor so far, and at 3 inches, probably the shortest. Oh, no, sorry. 5'3".
Ben, does your mum know you've come out to play with us?
I may be short, but I'm going to kick this course for a hit.
Yes, probably quite low on the shin. I love making short gags at other people's expense.
He does well. Or will be charged with cruelty to children.
Off goes baby Ben to the heavy bag beam. Oh, he'll be killed. Here we go. Look at his little legs go! Oh! Oops. That heavy bag must have looked huge to him. Imagine. Poor Ben. Might need a plaster after that brave little soldier. So it's Ben against those four nasty big balls. I'm loving this. Oh, here we go. Oh, congratulations, it's a bouncing baby boy. I am taller than him. I am. Actually, I am. On his way to earning his 5-metre swimming badge now. Get a certificate and everything. Little badges sewed on your trunks. That was just me. Ben must be used to swings, though, so here he goes. Oh. Of course, he's probably not allowed on the big boys' swings. Finally, big baby Ben climbs up the wooden hill to Bedfordshire in 3 minutes 50.
Oh, God!
Night-night, Ben.
Won't be a minute. I'm just,
you have now reached your destination.
There we go. Phew, all done. I love this podium. It is so useful for all those things I do with it. I really don't know what I'd do without it. Hang on, I've just remembered something I need to do that's podium related. Hold on. Yeah, all done. Anyway, time to rock out with the next competitor.
This is Anthony. He's a heavy metal rock god from Brighton.
Singer, power metal singer, band Sorcerer Spell. Hi, guys.
Oh, so you're a dainty warflower then, eh?
Most definitely not!
Uh-oh.
Time to teach this course a lesson in the use of ultimate power!
Oh, stop shouting! Ow! Right, off he goes. Oh, no, there's a problem. 1980s Lady Rock. He's not going to be happy with that, is he? This was always a bad moment in a club. Leave. This is awkward. Anyway, that aside, Anthony's heading to the heavy bags. Heavies. He looks happy. Maybe he doesn't mind a bit of Lady Rock. Here we go. Yep, looking good. Looking very good. Oh, wow! Just a little nick at the end, but great stuff there from Anthony. Oh, no, he's got a limp. Come on, Anthony. Yes. It's easy. Come on. Oh! Stops that fist with his face. Good job. This is looking strong. Oh! That's probably going to make his voice a little bit higher now. You know that bit when you go, ah! Big balls now. Oh! Oh! Not only does he love rock, he also drops like rock.
This is a rock-solid performance from Anthony.
Just a swing thing now. Come on, Anthony. Here we go. Oh, he broke a string. Despite that, the Brighton rocker reaches the finish in 3 minutes and 6 seconds. I was a rocker. I was. Small one. I think he's still annoyed at that music choice earlier. Ooh. Just in case there was any doubt, what kind of music did you like again? I think it said metal. Next to go is 20-year-old London gymnastics coach Kaylee. Bravo! How wonderful!
Gymnastics is easy, it'd be called football!
No, it wouldn't. It would be called easy nastics or gym ball, maybe. What am I talking about? This is looking good already. Oh, graceful! Will gymnastics help on their heavy bag beat? No! Almost. A faultless entry. I give it a million points. I don't know how they score gymnastics. Big balls now. Come on, Kaylee. Whoa, she was straight up! What an exquisite dismount. A double bounce with an arm flail. That's 20 billion and 5 points or something. Bet she can swim as well. Just the swing thing to go for Kaylee now, and this is looking like a very quick tie. Here we go. The swing. Onto the thing. She's landed it. Kaylee could be near the top of the leaderboard if she gets this right. One jump. Yes! No! Oh, I don't know. I think she even made that look graceful. So Grace Kaylee finishes her run in a very good 2 minutes 51. But where does that put her on the leaderboard? Granny McPhee takes the top spot with Grace Kaylee and the Brighton rocker below. In fourth, it's Big Band Simon with Satnav Nikki and Big Baby Ben taking the bottom two slots. But who'll challenge them next? This is Cassie. She's asleep. Oh, sorry, no, that went over the page. She's a sleep researcher. Right, work's over.
You don't snooze, you'll lose. And I'm fresh out of a nap, baby.
Really? OK, time to see if Cassie's snoozing helped her around the qualifier. I'm going to talk very quietly because I don't want to wake her up. There she goes now, climbing onto the podiums. I said, lovely, now the heavy bags. No! Yeah, she's gone bye-byes!
Sorry about shouting there, I got all excited. Onto the sucker punch now. Cassie needs to sleepwalk across this wall as quickly as possible. Yes, this is good. No, oh, that's put her lights out. Now for the big balls.
She's nodded off.
Well, this is bound to wake her up. One, two,
yahoo!
Yeah, that definitely woke her up. It will have done. Nobody's ever done this course of sleep before. Just a swing for Cassie now. Come on. No one's made it across intact yet today. Time to see if all that snoozing helped. Oh. No. No, it didn't. Cassie reaches the finish in a very good 3 minutes and 6 seconds. She'll probably have a celebratory snooze now. Oh, settle down. This is Peter from Seven Oaks. He sells artificial turf. Oh, I think they've got enough already, mate. Look, it's everywhere.
This is going to be wall-to-wall entertainment. Underlay, underlay!
Oh, it says here that Peter is a carpet salesman. Why was he holding artificial turf? And why the Mexican music? Oh, too many questions. Oh, underlay, underlay. I get it now.
Where's my...
Yeah, all right. Time for a heavy carpet bagging. See, there's a link. Oh, he got floored. That's another. That was a case of some heavy bag burn, followed by beam burn, and nicely rounded off with a touch of pole burn there. Ooh. Big balls now for the underlayer. Come on! Oh! I've never seen someone's head actually disappear like that. Amazing. It didn't come off, I think. Just the swing thing now. Come on! No, oh, no, he hasn't undone the rope! Oh, this is ridiculous. He might be great with a gripper rod, but he's not so hot with a tied-up bit of rope. Underlayer Peter reaches the finish mat in a rather good 2 minutes and 20 seconds.
Oh, Reba.
The swing thing may not sound like a very scientific obstacle, but in truth, science is the key to getting over it. Observe. Using sciencey computer graphics, you can see there's the swing, that's what contestants must use to swing on, over there, to the thing. Simple precision timings required. 35-year-old PR consultant Anna uses bad science. She actually forgot to swing there. 44-year-old sailing fan Moira sat down at the wrong moment and sank. That's bad science. And 31-year-old marketing manager Shahira had a sound swing. Good science.
Yep.
But poor timing. That's bad science. So Anna swung to the finish line in 5 minutes 15. Moira sailed onto the podium in 4 minutes and 1 second. But Shahira beat them both in a time of 3 minutes 33 because her science was at least 50% good. So, what have I learnt? Yep, absolutely nothing. This is cheeky northern chappy Mikey, and he's ready to rip up the qualifier. Check out the guns.
Fab, isn't it?
Good luck. Thanks.
And off goes cheeky northern Mikey. The 32-year-old nursery manager almost looks light enough to float over the water. OK, up to the heavy bag beam now. Here we go. No. Definitely a no. That toxic mud is going to play havoc with his hair gel. And his nose. Yeah, and his face there upstairs.
Come on, Spiky Mikey!
Come in.
Now, the lightweight Yorkshireman must take on the very heavyweight sucker punch.
Let his little legs go.
Right, he's on. Oh, looking good. Oh, cheeky blow to the face. But on he goes. Yes. Mikey on the big balls now. Here we go. Ha-ha! Oh! Oh! Oh, yeah! No. Aye, that'll cost him, huh? Now, for a swim, followed by a cheeky swing.
Oh, my goodness.
Come on, Mikey, do it for your three kids. They're watching. Yes. Yes, he made it! Katie, Matthew and Elliot will be going berserk right now.
He's a cheeky northern Mikey.
Yes! Cheeky Northern Mikey conquers the qualifier in 2 minutes 35. Cracking time. This is Paul. Don't be put off by the suit and earmuffs. This guy's done some impressive stuff.
I've taken a bike to China. I've gone to the magnetic North Pole in a challenge, and I'll say it's halfway around the world in a challenge, so...
Not much, then.
No, only little bits. Only little bits.
I'm here to win! One day, $1, one dream!
So the 53-year-old builder from Birmingham sets off on his least intrepid adventure to date, trekking across a couple of hundred yards of foam. There he goes, across the heavy bag beam, and incredibly he's made it! Looking good. Is there anything this man can't do? Come on. Onto the sucker punch. Ooh. No. How wrong is that? Ouch. Surely all that polar trekking will have helped Paul to prepare for this next challenge. The big red balls. Here we go. No, it didn't, did it? Didn't help at all. Paul of the Arctic's gone for a swim, and he may be sometime. The swing thing now for Paul of the Arctic, and here we go.
Come on, Paul.
Yes, come on, Paul. Oh, it's a timing thing. Oops. Might be slowed down a bit now. Probably best he let go. He could have been there forever. And Paul of the Arctic reaches the magnetic finishing pole in 2 minutes 8 seconds. The fastest time so far today. This is Kel. Oh, she's gone. Oh, she's back again. Oh, she's gone. Hang on, there she is. Oh, this is annoying.
So, Kelly, what exactly can you do out there on that crazy obstacle course?
To be honest with you, Amanda, Kel can do a lot. And I've been through this course in my mind about 1,000 times, and Kelcan knows exactly what she's going to do.
Before you ask, yes, I am going to win Total Wipeout. If anyone can, Kelcan.
I didn't ask. Wow, embarrassing. Kel's got odd socks on now. Oh, painful start. Onto the heavy bag beam, running for it, and she's made it.
Yes.
Kel's ability to not keep still for a second may be an advantage here on the sucker punch. Dodging. Ooh. Yes. Oh, no, maybe not. Oh, look, her socks match now. Okay, here we go. And... yeah, she sort of fell off. Just a swing thing to go. The swing safely onto the thing. Careful!
Oh, Kelly, careful.
Now she's steadied herself, preparing to leap. Yes, she can. She's made it.
Kel sort of can.
So where does that put sort of Kel on the leaderboard? Well, that superb run puts Kel joint top with Paul of the Arctic. Peter Underlay and Cheeky Northern Mikey are in fourth and fifth, whilst Night Night Cassie snoozes her way into joint seventh with the Brighton Rocket. At the bottom of the board, things are starting to look a bit grim for Shahira, Nikki and Ben. Meet Fran. She's from Bromsgrove. She runs a gym and she teaches yoga. The perfect CV for this show.
Drum roll, please. I think you're gonna go far today.
Oh, that was embarrassing.
It ain't how hard you can hit, it's how hard you can get hit.
I don't know about you, but I'm still getting over that Amanda pun. She just shouldn't try that sort of thing. So just... anyway, where am I? Oh, yes, Fran. Right, here she goes.
She's struggling.
Yeah, she is a bit. But now she's up. And now she's running. But can she outrun the heavy bags? Let's see. Here we go. Oh, nice tactics, waiting for the gap. This girl's got it all worked out. Might not be the fastest way to cross here, but this is good. If she avoids a fall, it'll save time. And she's across. Fran also teaches martial arts, so she's got the skills to cross the sucker punch. Probably. Doing well, though. Good footwork. Yes, she's across. Fran is yet to fall off anything. This is amazing. Now it's the big balls. One, two. Oh, this is unbelievable. Three, four. I don't believe it. She's made it. What an incredible achievement. Very few people have ever crossed all four balls like that. A golden total wipeout moment there. Simply fantastic. Wow. She doesn't even look surprised by herself. Now, can Fran make this a flawless performance? Finish it off now with the swing. Here we go. Oh! Oh, come on!
Cork!
Come on!
Cork. Oh! Did,
oh! No! She's proven herself a supreme athlete. No, that wasn't so fantastic. But Fran bounced to the top of the leaderboard with a time of 1 minute 57. That superb run is going to take some beating. Here's Luke. He's 21. He's from St. Helens and he loves singing and dancing. And his nan.
Would it be a fair description to say that you're a little theatrical?
A little bit, yes.
Why, what is it that you do?
I do a lot of acting, singing, dancing, yeah.
Can you give me like a demonstration of your best show tune?
Yes, I will. Oh, no problem. When I am down and all my soul so weak.
Oh, that was unfair. We're just getting going. Luke here is studying musical theatre in Manchester and one day hopes to work on a cruise ship. Singing, I mean, not steering the thing. Right, he's up and running, heading towards the heavy bag beam. Here we go. Determination. Yes! No! Oh, and he's in the water. A touch of the Little Mermaid would come in handy about. Onto the sucker punch next. Ooh, takes one to the mousetrap, but Luke's making good time. Oh, no. Right in the chitty-chitties. Bang, bang, you see. Now, how will chitty-chitty Luke perform on the big balls? Here we go. One, two. Oh! That had grease written all over it.
Raise me up to more than
now. And he's across. That's 1 second faster than Fantastic. Oh, come on, I liked his singing. This is Chris. He's a leader of beavers in the Scouts. I was in the Scouts once, and I promise I'm not going to take the mickey at all. It's inappropriate and unnecessary.
How do you rate your chances?
Pretty good, but we'll just see how things go. I'll take it one step at a time. You know, use my head.
Just don't use your head to hit off anything.
No, that wouldn't be a clever idea.
As a Scout, I'm always prepared, but is this course prepared for me?
Oh, I love this guy already. He's not done anything yet. Come on, Chris. Yes. You see? Here we go. Nope. Careful. Onto the heavy bags now. Yes. Oh, right in the ging-gang ghoulies. No, I wasn't going to do that. He might need that 5p he keeps in his pocket for emergencies. No. No. No scouting gags. I liked it. He's got his heavy bag badge. Time to try for the sucker punch badge. Here he goes. Oh! Ah! Probably like working at a bring and buy sale. That was all those angry grannies fighting over a tea cozy. No, stop making scouting gags, Hammond. I enjoyed it. I've learned a lot.
Actually looks like a bit of a beaver. An eager beaver.
Go on, Chris. Heave! That's it. Now it's time for some big ball bubba job. Come on. One, two, and in. Yes. Oh. Like I said before, I love this guy. Come on, Chris. And whilst Chris tries for his advanced lifesaver badge, I'll move on. Meet Becky, a 30-year-old personal trainer. Does she keep... Oh, it's a roar. Right, the beast is off. Yeah, the beast is struggling to climb a pontoon. Now, but she's... Mate, what does she do if she gets angry? I don't want to know.
Release the man beast, Becky. Release it.
I'm staying here. Now, both the man beast and the heavy bags are released. Simultaneously.
Not quite that way.
Becky jumped before it even touched her. What a scaredy man beast. Now onto the sucker punch. Should be no problem for this ball of rage. Look at that face! The rage, the fury! What does she do to it if she punches? Oh, it did.
She fell off. Yeah. Ball. A hairy moment for the beast there. Becky's definitely looking like some sort of beast now. Right, release the beast! Oh! Oh! I think the beast ripped something. Nasty. One last obstacle for this monstrous creature. But Becky's struggling to stand. Not a good sign. Here we go. Yes. Swing. Oh. Amanda always there with the encouragement that's needed. So a rather tired and soggy beast finishes in 2 minutes and 26.
Done.
Yes, yes, you're done. This is Policeman Sonny, and he's doing stuff with his hands.
This place is mustard, and this course is what I'm talking about. I'm about to serve some justice on a sucker punch. Come on!
What? Did he say something about custard? It's mud, not custard. Ooh, some serious foam burn there. Good work. Time to serve the sucker punch some justice. Yep, justice served. Sort of. I'm not going to say hello, hello, hello at any point, but what do we have here then? Oh! I'm afraid Sonny's going to be charged with breaking and entering. That's breaking bones whilst entering the water. Next, a tricky knot.
Come on, Sonny.
Well, come on, that's not an obstacle, that's just a start. It's undone and no, that's just poor. He may have fallen in, but at least he's landed sunny side up. Right, just the, well, the stairs to go. Come on, Sonny. Up you go. Just stairs. You got them at home, mate. Stairs. Sonny completes the course in 3 minutes 15 seconds, most of which was spent on the stairs. Oh, well, really. And from an officer of the law as well, I am disgusted. Back to Chris the Beaver, and as he reaches the swing thing, this is a very good time. Sonny is currently in 12th place with 3 minutes 15. Can Chris make the next round by beating this? This is his moment. Oh, he's stepping up to it. Come on, Chris. He can pull this out of the bag. I know he can. Yes! No! No. So close to landing it, too. But this is amazing stuff. Now he's got to swim, but what a run anyway. Chris has touched the void. He's crossed oceans. And continents. Only seconds away from beating Sonny's time. Come on! Yes! He's done it in 3 minutes and 12 seconds. Chris the Beaver is in the next round. What a guy! What a beaver! So, Chitty Chitty Luke Luke take the top spot, with Fantastic following closely behind. Sort of Kelly's joint third with Paul of the Arctic. But he's on the next screen because there's no space. The Beast comes in seventh, and of course, right at the bottom in 12th. It's Chris the Beaver pushing Sunnyside up, down, and out of the game.
The story doesn't end there, though. Sixth place Peter picked up an injury on the qualifier and had to retire. So, Sonny's luck is in. He now steps up to take the 12th spot in the next round. But a Saturday night elimination show wouldn't be complete without some sort of a sad montage. So it's time to get those tissues ready. Unless you're heartless. In which case, it's time to poke yourself in the eye. So, here goes. Ah!
Start. Only 5 will reach the summit. This is Crash Mountain. The contestants must successfully navigate their way over the rotating platform whilst trying to avoid getting a face full of sweeper off, which spins in the other direction. The first 5 to the centre are heading for more spinning in the next round. The other 7 are heading to the check-in desk because their tickets got all soggy. On podiums 1 and 2, it's Chitty Chitty Luke Luke.
Watch Mr. Muscle make it to that middle.
And
he's a cheeky northern Mikey.
Yeah. On 3 and 4, it's Chris the Beaver.
I might have been prepared before, I ain't anymore.
Pain is just weakness leaving your body, so bring it on!
And Frantastic. On 5 and 6, The Beast. And Paul of the Arctic.
They call me Peter Pan, now watch me fly!
On 7 and 8, Granny McPhee. And the Brighton Rocker.
Enough of this! It is time to destroy this mountain!
On 9, 10 and 11, Sort of Kel. Sunny Side Up. And Night Night Cassie. And finally, on podium 12, it's Grace Cayley.
I can backflip on a beam, so this one should be a walk in the park.
Mount Everest, K2, the Eiger. Hardest peaks to climb? Not anymore. Forget the Matterhorn. This is the Splatterhorn. It's Crash Mountain. Ready? Yeah! Unsteady. 3, 2, 1.
Off goes the honker and around goes the mountain. Who will be first to try? Oh, it's Fee. What's this, Kel having a go? Unbelievable! Sort of Kel really can. Not even gone round once yet, but Kel's already made it to the centre. What a start. So off goes Chris. Oh, he is off. And Becky, only 4 places left. Who will join Kel in the next round? There's Kaylee. Oh, and off. Who's next? Here's Anthony trying. Oh, what a stage dive from the Brighton Rocker.
That was never going to happen, was it?
No. Nah. Chris the Beaver picking his moment. Ah, there's Frantastic. Right, who's going to go for it now? Who's next? Oh, it's Mikey. Ah, oh, so close. That looked cheeky and painful.
Sonny, you're still dry.
Yeah, get on with it. Come on. Sonny there being a sleeping policeman. He's woken up. Oh, no, he hasn't. Back to sleep. Biding his time. Nearly. Come on, Sonny. Get on with it. Here we go. No. Yeah. Come on, Luke. Climb every mountain. Well, that one. Anyway. He's on and he is... Oh, he's up. Oh, my... He said the chitty's knocked out of him there. Bang, bang. Kaylee's go now. Come on. Biding her time, choosing her moment. Here we go. Yes, she's going to do it. Oh, no! That was so close. Someone's got to make this soon. Who's next? Paul of the Arctic gives it a go. And, oh, no. Nice try. Let's not forget Kel. Getting pretty lonely in the middle now, all on her own. Surely someone's got to join her soon. Here goes Fran. She's up. No. Paul trying again. He's down. Becky. Straight in. Here's Night Night Cassie.
Up and run.
Yes, you really can't afford to fall asleep here. This is all about timing. Come on, Cassie. Come on. Yes. Yes. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, that was a rude awakening. Ow. 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 Surely someone's going to cross this soon. Ah, no, not Finn. Poor Luke. Kaylee's on again. Come on, Kaylee. Still 4 places left in the next round. Choosing a moment. Yes. Finally, Kaylee joins Kel in the next round.
2 chicks. I love it.
Chris Neff.
Come on, Chris.
I don't know if I've mentioned it, but I love this guy. Come on, Chris. Yes. 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 And I believe this Chris is through. He deserves that. Yeah. And Paul now. Oh, that's outrageous. It all just kicked off. Just 1 place remains in the next round. So, will it be Fee, Luke, Sonny, Fran, Mikey, Anthony, Cassie, or the Beast? Nope, not the Beast. Or Anthony, or Luke. So who's it going to be? Here's Mikey, up and running, and he's made it! Well, that incredible effort means Mikey, Kaylee, Kel, Chris and Paul are through to the next round. And while those five Crash Mountaineers progress to the next round, what becomes of the seven losers? Well, who cares? Sorry, I misread that. Let me try it again. Well, who cares if they were eliminated? They're all still heroes to me. Apart from the irritating one, I just...
I ran and I dived and I ran and I dived. I couldn't get to grips with Crash Mountain at all.
The Kung Fu cop got hooked and booked today. He didn't come up with the goods.
It was just so hard. I just tried my best. I tried everything I could every time, so...
I'm well fit. You know what? I'm well wet now.
I was running, I was fine, and then I think just seeing the sweeper arm come in just made me veer off the sides. I'm very upset.
I've got no idea what happened up there. I saw sun, I saw sky, and yeah, then I just lost my memory.
It looks a lot easier than it is. I'll tell you that, boys and girls.
I think Kel Can probably could win it. I mean, she's got a very good attitude.
Oh, Chris, she's a trooper. I'm right behind you, Chris. You go and get him, son.
Good luck to all of them.
It's Dizzy Dummies. Got my checklist here, so I'm gonna check things. Spinny thing that goes round for 40 seconds. Check. Squirty man, the shapes. Tippy table maze. Check. Loser. Check. And then second time round, it's more of the same spinning, crazy beams, ball tossers. Check. Another loser. Check. Three finalists, one of whom will get a big fat check. Check.
Run, hide. It's big, it's scary, and it's about to wreak havoc on the contestants' stomachs. It's Dizzy Dummies, and it's a beast. Are you ready?
No!
3, 2, 1!
As the longest 40 seconds of their lives begins, it's time to meet them all over again. She's a gymnast called Kaylee.
Gymnastics was easy, it'd be called football!
No, it would be called... Oh, anyway, it's Grace Kaylee. He's cheeky. He's northern.
I'm coming!
He's a cheeky northern Mikey.
She sort of can, and she's called Kel.
Kel Can knows exactly what she's going to do.
It's sort of Kel. Sort of, I think. First the Arctic, and now Total Wipeout. Nowhere left to conquer.
One day, $1, one grain!
It's Paul of the Arctic. He's my favourite, and I'm not just saying that.
As a scout, I'm always prepared, but this is course prepared for me.
It's Chris the Beaver. So the Dizzy Dummies are released and immediately get a hosing from the Squirty Man. Oh, that's Kel. Away. That's ridiculous. She sort of fell over. And Kaylee's off. She's first through the shapes, but three others are down. Ooh, what up there? And Paul's through. Kaylee first up onto the tippy table maze, edging her way along. There goes Chris the Beaver. Majestic sight. Ooh, Kaylee racing her way across there. But Paul is hot on her heels. Oh, cheeky northern Mikey is in. Yes, she can.
She's so light.
She's not even moving the table. That's amazing. Oh, how easy did she make that look? Kaylee is first through to the next round. Right, who's going to be next over? Paul's looking good. Here comes Mikey. Oh, no, he took them both out.
Mikey's in trouble.
Mikey's still on the table, but how will he get out of that little predicament? Here comes Chris the Beaver. Come on, Chris. Looking good. Oh, Mikey's through.
Yes!
So it's just a straight race between Chris and... Oh, Dozy. He'll have to go back to the start now. OK, the lead handed to Kel now. No, no!
Come on, Paul! You're nearly there!
So Paul's go now. He is nearly there. Come on, just one jump. Yes! And Paul of the Arctic is through. Got to remain impartial here, but... come on, Chris! Oh, Kel is coming down the outside. And she's made it. That was fabulous. But it does mean Chris the Beaver is out. Life just isn't fair sometimes.
You used my counterweight.
Chris, I'm so proud of you for getting this far. Hard luck, my man. Go sit down with the others.
Thank you very much.
See you later.
Just four survivors remain. Who will be first to be sick? Let's watch. Nah, none of them. Good. So the spinner stops. Kaylee is first out past Mr. Squirty and she is straight onto the shapes. Kel close behind or in front. And she's through. Ah, there's a tosser de las bolas. The girls really are out in front. Mikey at the back, Paul just getting onto the beams. Sort of Kel heading the field now with Kaylee and Paul of the Arctic steaming down the outside. Oh, they are getting a pounding from the tossers. Kel sort of edging herself along the beam, being cautious, staying in front. Here comes Mikey. Yes! Oh, dear. What did he do there? Oh, I see. With that duck into the water, it could all be over now for cheeky northern Mikey. This is serious. If these three make it to the other side, Mikey will be out. And Kel is first across. She's in the wipeout zone. Yeah! Kaylee and Paul queuing in a very British fashion. Here comes Mikey with a last-ditch attempt. Yes, and Kaylee is through to the wipeout zone.
We have a two-girl final, people.
And Paul is through. And that means there's no more cheeky northern Mikey.
Mikey, my poor little Spike. Ah, talk to me. What happened? You just weren't quick enough out of the gate?
Just wasn't quick enough that time. I didn't get off that bit quick enough.
Well done. Hard luck. Go join the others. See you later.
Thank you. See you later. And good luck to these guys.
16 losers. 3 finalists. 1 wipeout zone. Just in case you're not appreciating what I'm doing here, I'm establishing a witty pattern of saying a number followed by a related fact. What, I'll do some more. 1 total wipeout trophy, £10,000. I've run out of numbers and stuff. Hang on. 3 finalists getting emotional.
I found out that I am actually quite good at toe wipeout. I didn't think I'd get this far.
It's been a challenge, it's been a hard challenge, and I'm in the final.
It feels absolutely amazing to be in the final. Just kept going and kept going, thinking about the prize money, what it'll mean, you know, my friends, everyone at home.
All the kids I teach and all the girls at the gym already look up to me, but I think they will even more now.
My kids, they're very supportive of whatever I do, and I think when I get home, they're going to be so proud that I have got it.
Older than my dad, and I can't imagine my dad getting this far, so I think he's done really, really well.
Paul is a good competitor, but at the end of the day, he is an old guy.
Kaylee, I feel, really threatened by her. She's quick, she's nimble, she's going to be very good on the balancing part.
To be completely honest, in the first few rounds, I didn't really fear her as a competitor, but once I saw her on Dizzy Dummies whizzing past me, I started to realise just how good she is.
Kaylee is a threat to me. She is a very pumped-up person. She's out to win.
I am a bit worried about her because she's so determined and ambitious. She's not going to give up. I don't really want to win. I don't want to do the wipeout zone for no reason because it's the most one I'm scared about.
If I win, what a bonus. And if I don't, that's where it goes.
There's only one person that's going to win this final. Kel can.
the Wipeout Zone starts with a terrifying tumble down the killer surf. Then it's the rapid climb, a headlong dash with only 10 seconds before the tidal wave is released. Then it's the seesaw of truth to the crazy sweeper, and a rope swing to the turntable, and a final leap to the finish pole. The fastest wins a massive trophy and £10,000 towards a massive trophy cabinet.
What a feast we have for you tonight. It's like a great big bloke sandwich. On one side, we have Kelly. On the other, we have Kaylee. And in the middle, like a slice of ham, we have Paul. This is the Wipeout Zone, and Kaylee is the first to go.
Gymnastics coach Kaylee is graceful, but will she be fastest?
Wish me luck!
Good luck!
Not a smooth landing, but then things rarely go smoothly on the Wipeout Zone.
Come on, Kaylee!
She's in and must swim now. To the rapid climb. Come on, if she's not at the top in 10 seconds, a tidal wave will make it a whole lot worse for Kaylee. To slow swim. Come on. Come on. Almost up. There. She's on and the countdown begins. Once she's on, she's quick, looking good. She's going to beat the tidal wave. Yes. Onto the seesaw. This should be no problem for this gymnastics coach. Just a case of balance. Clearly, it is no problem. Oh, no, she's not heavy enough to tip it. There it goes. Great balance. Cleared. Onto the crazy sweeper, taking a moment to compose herself. Starting a run. Oh, careful. Took one to the head, but she's up again. Quick as a shot. Come on, Kaylee, this is looking good. And she's across. Kaylee hasn't made a single error yet, and let's hope it stays that way. She makes a swing. And lands it smack bang in the centre of the turntable. Expertly done. Just one jump to the finish podium now. And that's it. Yes! Stops the clock on 1 minute 37 seconds, a very, very fast Wipeout Zone run. Kaylee appeared to be dawdling a bit at the start, but a near perfect run, save for that bonk on the head, means Kaylee's set a very hard benchmark to beat.
Come on out, my darling. Oh my goodness, I can't believe I was ever slightly worried about you.
I was worried myself.
You breezed through that in 1 minute and 37 seconds.
Oh, did I?
Yes! Would I lie to you, Kaylee?
No.
Such a fantastic time. It is the time to beat. But Kelly's up next, and we know Kelly can do.
Kelly can.
Let's watch.
Sort of Kel needs to be sort of brilliant to beat Kaylee.
Watch very closely. This one's fine.
Okay, good luck. Wow, Kel straight out of that ring and swimming towards the rapid climb. That was a fast start. Kel really is going to have to put in a faultless performance if she's going to beat Kaylee's amazing 1 minute 37. Come on. She's at the base of the rapid climb.
Where's Kelly? There's Kelly!
Yep, she's up and on, and those 10 seconds start ebbing away, but Kel flying up the rapid climb. That was very quick indeed. Onto the seesaw. Kel needs to focus here and stay balanced. A fall here would be disastrous. That's it. Reaches the tipping point. Takes it in a stride. And she's cleared it. This is where Kaylee lost a meagre few seconds. Chance now for Kel to steal the lead. Gets as close as she can and waits for her moment. Off she goes. Oh, ducks. This has to be it. Come on, Kel, this is quick. Incredible, Kel's across, neck and neck with Kaylee now. Not that she knows it, of course. She needs a good swing and a safe landing here. The swing's good. Oh, bumpy landing, but Kel's up on her feet. This is really close. one jump. Wow! Just 3 seconds slower than Kaylee, the Wipeout Zone can be so cruel. It was a fantastic run, but in the end, sort of Kel sort of couldn't. She's out of the running. Time for Amanda to break that news.
Well done, Kelly. Oh my goodness, that was absolutely incredible. How are you feeling?
A little bit tired, but I'm all right.
There were but 3 seconds between you two. Kelly, I'm afraid you were 3 seconds slower than Kaylee. Oh, hard luck, Kelly. Go join the others. But Kaylee, you know what this means!
I need Paul to fall off!
Yours is now the time to beat. Let's watch Paul. Good luck!
Paul and the Arctic must now trek to the finishing pole in under 1 minute 37.
I'm in the Total Wipeout final!
Yeah, you are. That's a good start. He knows where he is. Now get on with it. Looks like a dose of whiplash on hitting the water there. But Paul making a strong, focused swim to the rapid climb. Time can be made up here.
Well, he's a strong swimmer, but that doesn't mean he's going to be a strong runner.
Kaylee and Kel both hurtled up this slope and beat the tidal wave. So Paul needs to do the same if he's to be in with a chance of winning today. Countdown starts. He's up. Is he looking good? Yeah, that might have been even quicker than the other two. Incredible. Seesaw next. Steady. Another perfectly executed tip. Paul is in with a strong chance here. Crazy sweeper, he cannot afford a fall here. He sets off. Is he going to duck? Oh, no, he's trying to do it in one. This is ambitious. Oh, unbelievable. That was so close. Paul's in the lead going into the rope swing. He can't afford a slip up here. And he's done it. Yes. 1 minute 12. Unbelievable. Well, Paul has every reason to be happy. He's just won £10,000 with a flawless display on the Wipeout Zone. But he didn't see the other two runs, so he's about to get the good news.
How are you feeling, my man?
Tired, but great. That was good.
Paul, I have to tell you, Kaylee, you have been a surprise little package here all day. Paul, as you know, you're old enough to be Kaylee's granddad. But that has not stopped you here tonight because you are the Total Wipeout champion!
So, Paul Craig from Birmingham, a man who's conquered nearly everything, will face one last challenge when he's joined by Kel and Kaylee in the series final. So, it's goodbye from Amanda and me. But first, here are three reasons why you should watch next time. Reason one. Reason two. And if there was any doubt... If any of this is strangely appealing to you and you fancy being on the next series of Total Wipeout, please go to bbc.co.uk/beontheshow and fill out an application form. Oh.
How tall is Sylvester Stallone? Taller than Richard Hammond, I'm guessing. Nick Knowles follows next with A Secret Fortune. Tomorrow night here on BBC One, he's hosting the BAFTAs, but Jonathan Ross is on the Top Gear track over on BBC Three in a second.